Hello friends, welcome to my channel. If you are looking for some DIY mods or projects that you want to do by using the off-the-shelf products or regular products that you get in the market without breaking your wallet, you have come to the right place. So stay tuned, keep watching, and if you like my videos, don't forget to hit like and subscribe below. Thank you.
In my previous video, I showed you all how to paint the spoiler with Plastidip and also mount it with a no drill method. In today's video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover two DIY mods. One is plaster dipping the wheels, and the second one is painting your calipers. But before we begin, let me show you the cost involved in the project so that you know you get an idea of how much it's going to break your wallet. So let's begin.
So as you can see, my wheels are off. What I've done is I've used a jack stand for the front and the vehicle jack for the rear, and these are the calipers. They are not rusty and they are pretty much clean. So if you want, you can also go ahead and remove the calipers. There are the two mounting bolts on the bracket, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint them while they are mounted, and also plaster dip the wheels. Let's first begin with masking. This is a very important step before you start spraying the calipers. Use a painter's tape as well as plastic sheets that you have lying at your house, or you can also use the dustbin bags to do this. Make sure you cover all the wheel area so you don't overspray. Use a utility knife to cut the excess masking tape of the caliper. Now what I'm going to do is use a concentrated brake cleaner spray and a brush. So the front calipers are pretty clean, so I don't have to do much work here. But make sure the surface is clean, else the paint won't stick. Alright, we are ready for spraying now. So for the first coat, just dab it a bit. Don't overspray. You just want to make sure the first coat stays on and dries so that the next coats stick to the surface perfectly. This is how the first coat should look like. The same thing we are going to do on the rear calipers. As you can see, there's a lot of dust here. So I'm going to use a steel wire brush and clean it before spraying the brake cleaner spray. Use ample amount of brake cleaner spray so that all the brake dust, grime and rust is taken out. Start masking the brake disc. What you can do is you can wrap the masking tape around and move the disc a bit further. I'm going to use the Duplicolor engine red ceramic spray paint. I didn't get the caliper paint, but it's one and the same. So it withstands a lot of heat, around 500 Fahrenheit, and has a nice ceramic finish to it. While the calipers dry out, let's begin with cleaning our wheels. I'm going to use a toothbrush and a brake cleaner spray. If you do not have a pre-dip spray, you can use a brake cleaner spray or any cleaner spray. Make sure all the crevices and edges of the spokes are clean. So use a brush where it's hard to reach. Use a clean cloth to clean it. Now what we are going to do is we are going to use the dip release. This is very important step, guys, do not miss this. There's another method of using index cards or masking the tires, but this is the best and easiest method. Apply dip release on the tires. This will make sure that the plastic dip, which is oversprayed on the tires, come out very easily. It's very easily peelable. And this does not cost much. This is just $3, but it saves you a lot of pain later on. After applying the dip release, I'm again going to clean the wheels one more time. Make sure the edges are clean, else the plastic dip won't stick to the edges. It's a very important step. Clean it perfectly. There should be no dip release, no grime, no wax on your wheels before you start spraying. So let's begin spraying. What I've done is for 15 minutes, I have put the cans into warm water. This way it atomizes better. So we are going to use luxury metal, black sapphire, and I'm going to use 2 coats of plastic dip matte black to begin with. So as you see, I'm putting a can gun onto the spray nozzle. Let's begin spraying. I'm going to use this cardboard partition to block the wind. It's a bit windy today, so I'm just using this. The first coat, which is also called as the tack coat, should be light. Shake the can rigorously before spraying and spray it lightly. Even if you get like 50% coverage, that is fine. Make sure you start with the edges and then spray the spokes and other areas. We're done with the tack coat. So I'm going to let it dry for 15 minutes before spraying the next coat. So I have got some rundowns. So don't worry. What you can do is while it's wet, you can scrap it off and again apply some plastic dip before drying. So I just, wipe the paint off. And now what I'm going to do is just apply few layers of plastic dip only in the area which I just scrubbed. And this is why plastic dip is very forgiving. Even if you make mistakes, you can rectify them immediately. You don't have to redo the entire stuff. Spray very light coat into the areas you scrub. Don't spray it all over so that this matches, level matches the areas which you have already plastered up. We are ready for the second coat. So the second coat should be wet. Start with the edges again. It should be nice wet coat. Go slow. Make sure you see the wetness into the paint and cover each and every area. Make sure you don't spray from far off. Plastic dip needs to be sprayed from as close as possible, around 3 to 4 inches. This is how it looks after drying for 10 minutes. I'm very happy with the results. You can see the surface is very smooth, neat and clean. There are no rundowns or oversprays or no missed spots. So what we are going to do is we are going to now start spraying the luxury metal. So we are going to have 7 coats in total, 2 base coats of Plasti-Dep matte and 3 coats of luxury metal. This should be wet coats, nice, slow, easy and steady. Don't overspray it, spray the areas of the lug nuts properly. These are the weak points, else the paint would come out while installing the wheels. I'm going to let it dry for another 15 minutes and then I'm going to do another 2 rounds of sprays. For the last 2 rounds of sprays, what I'm going to do is rotate the wheel 180 degrees, note the position of the valve and make sure you rotate it 180 degrees so that the areas that are not covered are also sprayed properly. While the paint was drying, I left the can into hot water so that the can does not get cold and still it atomizes properly. Let's begin with our final coats and let it dry for another 15-20 minutes. This is the final result. I've let it dry for almost an hour now. Aren't they looking beautiful, guys? I'm sure they're going to add a nice classy touch to the car. Let me also show you how easy it is to peel off the Plasti-Dep. This is because we use the dip release. So just pull off from the edge in the outwards direction. And it is very easy. It comes out in few seconds. For rest of the area, just use your wheel brush to scrub off the excess Plasti-Dep. It comes off pretty easily and then just use a cloth to wipe it off. This is it. We are ready to mount it now. What I have done is I have also Plasti-Dep the lug nuts. I'm not sure how durable they are going to be because we're going to use the impact gun to mount them. In the meantime, I also did few coats on the calipers. I just wanted to show you how they look after 3 coats. This is the final result after drying. They look nice, glossy, bright red. It's going to look beautiful with the black wheels. I mounted the wheels on the car. This is the end result. I'm really loving it. Let me know how you feel about this project. So this is how the red calipers and black wheels look when the car is on the roll. Aren't they beautiful? Please let me know your feedback. Thank you.